I never did a follow-up fit before, but I knew it would happen eventually. I just didn't think it would be on Jack the Ripper. This fit dates from the 11th of November 2016, and of course I will link it at the end of this one. But why this follow-up fit? Well, let's find out. This is a series where I tell you a story, its subsequent theories and explanations, and then I let you make up your mind. Today, my first follow-up fit. Could the mystery be solved? Could it be that H.H. Holmes and Jack the Ripper are one and the same person? H.H. Holmes was born Herman Webster Mudgett on the 16th of May, 1861. Some described him torturing animals and suffering from abuse at the hands of a violent father, but contemporary and eyewitness accounts of his childhood do not provide proof for either of it. When Holmes was later suspected of murder, he claimed to be nothing but an insurance fraudster. He admitted to using cadavers to defraud life insurance companies several times in college. Creepy. He later built a massive three-story hotel in Chicago that took up the entire block of the 63rd and Wallace streets. It had an elaborate maze of death traps, including trapdoors in floors and ceilings and greased chutes that funneled his hapless victims to the basement of the building. There, Holmes went about skinning and dissecting bodies before dissolving them in acid. The hotel would later be nicknamed the Murder Castle. Yeah, aptly named at that. Holmes confessed to 27 murders, but some believe he murdered over 200. He is said to be America's first serial killer. As I said before, I already have a fit up about Jack the Ripper that will be linked at the end of this one. So let's just summarize the Ripper story here. He was active in the impoverished parts in and around the Whitechapel district of London. And the victims were female prostitutes who lived in the slums. Their throats were cut and their organs removed with what seemed surgical precision. The five victims positively linked to the Ripper are called the Canonical Five, murdered between the 31st of August and the 9th of November in 1888. The Canonical Five were killed at night in or near the weekend, and the mutilation became increasingly brutal. So Jack and Holmes are both real-life monsters. Jeff Mudgett, a qualified lawyer and former commander in the US Naval Reserve, now claims his great-great-grandfather, H.H. Holmes, was in fact Jack the Ripper. Jeff Mudgett's quest started when he came into the possession of the so-called Holmes Diaries, in which he finds compelling evidence that the Whitechapel murders were training sessions and done to cause sensation in the country to distract from his own murders and sexual organ harvest of upper-class women. Rich women's ovaries would supposedly have healthier hormones in them to aid in Holmes' pursuit of a huge serum that would allow him to live an unnaturally long life. All very well, but we need evidence, dude. According to Mudgett, both killers look very similar, In 2006, a robot photo of Jack the Ripper was constructed from the 13 most reliable witness reports of the time, and he had it compared with an existing photo of Holmes, and the results were allegedly astounding. The ears, jawbones, and shape of the eyes were remarkably similar. Okay, so an almost 130-year-old photo looks similar to a robot photo made up from written down reports of the same era. Moreover, police at the time described the Ripper as 1 meter 70 or 5 feet 7, between 63 and 73 kilos or between 140 and 160 pounds, and between 25 and 35 years old. Holmes was 1 meter 70 or 5 feet 7, 68 kilos or 150 pounds, and 27 years old. Okay, now it becomes interesting. The canonical murders are considered by many to have been executed with precise medical precision. Holmes had a medical degree from the University of Michigan's Department of Medicine and Surgery. So he was a doctor, but was he there during the murders? Letters supposedly suggest Holmes had a desire to go to London. And from his diaries, Mudgett deduces Holmes was in London from July 1888 to January 1889. The first canonical murder was in August 1888, the last in November 1888. Holmes was foremost known as a con man, and as such he had several aliases, of which some appear on ships' manifests during the right times. Mudgett also says traveling during that time was much easier. So, he was possibly in England at the right time. Compelling! Many of the supposed letters the Ripper wrote are thought to be fake, but there is an interesting one called the Dear Boss letter, which accurately predicted the removal of the next victim's right ear. A handwriting expert said they had compelling similarities with the letters and the transcripts from the diaries from Holmes, and he declared them to be of the same man. Since that is inadmissible in court, Mudgett turned to the University of Buffalo, where they created a computer program that compares handwriting, and it gave an unprecedented 96.75% similarity between the handwritings. Stunning! Many people are not convinced, because of the difference in MO between the methodical Holmes and the almost hysterical sexual sadism of the Ripper. They also claim the Dear Boss letter not definitively proven to be from the Ripper, and all evidence is circumstantial. And then there is Thomas Bond, who wrote the earliest surviving offender's profile on the Ripper, and who was opposed to the idea that the murders had any kind of scientific or anatomical knowledge. The last one is from my research on the first Ripper fit I did. So, not solved, just yet. Jeff Mudgett wrote a book called Bloodstains, and he was involved in a History Channel series called American Ripper. We both have a lot more information on this, so I suggest you either read it and or watch it. I thought the series was very interesting. So here is the great-great-grandson of one of the most horrible people saying that his great-great-grandfather is even worse than everybody thinks. Or is he just connecting some dots at random? You decide. If you wish to do your own research, the links in the description might be a good start. If I forgot something or you have something to add, don't hesitate to do so. Your thoughts and opinions are much appreciated, so drop a line in the box below. Just be respectful in the comments, as there are real people with real feelings on the other side. If you enjoyed this vid, you can like, share and subscribe. And you may want to click the little bell to receive some notifications. I have my Raphael Worlds channel you might want to check out. And I hope to see you next time. Bye!